Hey astrology lovers, this is your astrologer, Julia Mihas, with Luna and Keyshawn, and I'm going to tell you what's in the stars for November. This month, the United States is going to elect its next president. So how does the sky look around Election Day on the 3rd? Well, Mercury is still going to be retrograde, and this planet rules all forms of information and communication, which includes voting ballots, the press, and propaganda. There's also going to be a tight square with Saturn and Pluto, and both these planets rule the government in different capacities. So basically, I think this is going to be a bureaucratically messy election year. Mercury retrograde likes to redo things, so there also might be lots of recounts. This looks like a recipe for misinformation and disinformation, where both sides might be convinced that they won. The last time that the presidential election happened during Mercury retrograde was 2000. Buckle up, kids, because it's going to be a bumpy ride. Now there's a witchy new moon in 23 degrees Scorpio on the 15th, and it has easy aspects from the mystical planets Neptune and Jupiter. This new moon may bring premonitions, intuitions, and visionary dreams in its wake. Then November's going to close with a full moon in 8 degrees Sagittarius. This full moon is all about communication and intellectual exploration, but there's also a kinky quincunx from astrology's whack job Uranus, which reminds us that opinions are like a body part which everyone has and thinks is important. Just try not to be so rigid about your thinking around then. Then Mars is finally going to go direct on the 14th, so it's going to join some of the other outer planets which are pivoting forward again. The greater infrastructure of our society will slowly start to work better, and early next year we're going to have all the outer planets direct and moving fast. That means it's going to be an awesome time for any new enterprise, project, or venture that you want to initiate. I'm making astrology videos every month, so subscribe to my channel so you can know what the cosmic influences are gonna mean for you. Hey Aries, so Mars finally goes direct in your first house of self, which means that you're finally gonna be able to move forward on many projects which have given you nothing but frustrations recently. Now you can begin to assert yourself without running into as many flare-ups with other people. Instead of going from 0 to 60 when you're pissed off, you're now only going from like 0 to 50, which is progress, I guess. So Venus, the relationship planet, starts the month off in her favorite house, which is the 7th, because this is the house of partnership. Now this transit is awesome for your relationship. Enjoy some romance with your boo and plan a date night, because your honey is looking extra hottie and they're gonna be kind of pleasant to be around too. If you're single, then get on that dating app because you can strike when the iron's hot. Then when Venus enters your 8th house of hot sex and emotional intimacy on the 22nd, you can take your relationship to a much deeper and steamier level. So Mercury goes direct on the 4th in your 7th house of partnership, where it's Venus is also. If there's been any confusion or mixed messages in your relationship, you can finally clear the air now. Mercury is furthest away from the Sun on the 10th this month, which means that you can gain a great deal of clarity on your relationship. Then the planet of thinking enters your house of research on the 11th. Dig deep on something if you have to, but don't fall into an abyss of paranoia, because when you stare deeply into the gaping void, the void begins to stare back at you. Spooky. Thanks for watching. Hopefully I haven't put you to sleep like these guys. If you want to see more videos on astrology, then please subscribe to my channel because I can desperately use the validation. Ciao for now.